Welcome to this Sheffield Steelers Legends of Hockey DVD. Over the next hour, we'll be taking you behind the scenes of the weekend, catching you up with one or two familiar faces, and reminiscing with players on their time at the club. The Legends weekend started at the Steelers shirt launch at Queen's Road.
Queen's Road ice rink. 21 years ago, the Sheffield Sabres used to play here. Of course, the Sheffield Sabres 20 years ago became the Sheffield Steelers, playing out of the Sheffield Arena. You know, the Sheffield Steelers teams of the past, the great Steelers team, even the 2001 Grand Slam team, they still used to practice in this old building. Of course, this old building is now a roller rink. And tonight, as you can see, many Sheffield Steelers fans are here to celebrate the Sheffield Steelers team of 2011-2012. It's the Unison Sheffield Steelers shirt launch. It's the start of a great weekend. Great heroes of the past, Vial, Lafreniere, Perron, Cranston, Plommer, Shudra, Blaisdell, Dampier, they're all here. I wonder if in another 20 years' time, the Sheffield Steelers team of 2011 and 12 will be treated as legends. These fans certainly hope so. Victoria Hotel. It's Friday night before the Saturday of the Festival of Hockey. The Steelers of 2011-12 are here, the sponsors are here, yeah, and the legends are here as well, so it could go on quite a while. Cranston, Lafreniere, they're already in full flow. Go and join them. So joined by three Steelers legends, well, two and Mark LaFave, Rob Wilson, Timo Wilman and Mark LaFave. Willie, good to be back.
Yeah, great to be back. It's great to see everyone you haven't seen in a long time. It brings back a lot of memories, and like, it's nice just going, but looking forward to the rest of it. Should be a great night.
And Timo, you've been on the ice once already. Looking forward to skating out of the arena again.
Oh yeah, I do. Like, our team looks good, so what's up, Cardiff? We're going to win.
You're going to win?
Yeah.
Mark, I can't really ask you much about the team because one night with Jason Lafreniere, and unfortunately, you didn't make practice.
I had a little bit of a lie in today. I got to save my energy for the game tomorrow, but I'll blame that on Lafreniere for last night.
Okay. You know all about drinking with Jason Lafreniere. And
well, I don't. I didn't drink. I didn't drink, but Jason might add one or two.
He might have a drink.
But, no, you know what? Jason can handle it. He'll be ready to go, I guarantee you.
Okay. This team, it's a great bunch of guys everybody's got together. It's like none of you have been away, isn't it?
Yeah, you know what? Hockey's like that. Hockey's like that. I don't think anything else, whether it's business, whatever, has the same camaraderie as what a dressing room and hockey has. And guys, you just pick up where you left off, maybe ask a few questions what you've been up to, and then you take it from there. And it's great to see everybody. Everyone's having a good time already, so...
And Timo, when I called you a few weeks ago and said you fancy coming, you jumped at the chance. It was a great year you had here with the Steelers, wasn't it?
It was fun. It was a great year. We got two championship titles. So, you know what? I was thrilled. Just thrilled. Thank you.
Yeah, and Favor, of course, you were part of a championship team as well.
Yeah, it's great to see all the guys back here, like Mike Perron and Rocket Ron and Blazers here as well. So it's good to see all these guys that you won a title with, so it's great.
Is it bed early for you tonight?
Not at all. Not at all. I go back to my hot spots I used to go to when I lived here, so.
Thank you.
Two members of the 2001 Grand Slam team, David Longstaff and Dennis Vial. Dennis, great to see you back in Sheffield.
I'm glad to be back here, and I'm honored to be invited back here to Sheffield and playing this Legends game.
The Queen Mother couldn't make it, but Dennis Vial wears the Steelers top once more.
Yes, I will. Can't wait.
You can't wait? Big character Denzel wasn't he? He was a great part of that 2001 team.
Ah, he was good. In the dressing room and on the ice, he was a presence that no one else could match, so... I think he was a lot to do with us winning everything that year.
Good for you to be back here as well with all your old mates.
Yeah, I love it. I'm back with all the old players that I used to play with, and I'm some of the young Steelers that I went away in the World Championships with. So I suppose I'm a little bit in the middle, but it's great to see everyone again.
And I'm sure when the game starts tomorrow, it'll be a bit of fun. But people like you can't just play for fun. It's competitive. We're going to win the game. I heard you and Blaze are talking about winning both games.
Yeah. Yeah, I know when you play there for fun, but then once you start playing, you just like the, the game takes over and you just, it's just the intensity, just the mentality of it. We just want to win.
And that little rat Sacratini, if you can get hold of him. What do you reckon, David? Do you reckon the little rat Sacratini could be in for it tomorrow?
Well, I'll be honest with you, I've seen Dennis today and I think Sacratini might give him a good hiding, so we'll wait and see what happens.
Okay, boys, enjoy your night.
Thank you, Dave.
Here's the man who's going to give all the penalties out tomorrow, especially to Ron Shudra, Nico Toman. Nico, thanks for coming in.
No problem.
Already you can see it's a great event the whole weekend, isn't it?
Yeah, it's good fun. See the old guys back. It's a lot of fun, honestly.
You could see today, we watched the guys practice and they love to be back at the ring. Yeah. Do you miss it as well, not being involved?
Well, I'm still involved a little bit in Belgium. I'm director of the Federation, but for the rest, I'm not on the ice anymore.
Do you miss that banter?
Yes, I miss. Sometimes I miss, but not a lot. The last time I skated was 5 years ago, so
right.
It's going to be fun tomorrow.
It'll be fun tomorrow. And, of course, Sheffield and Cardiff, you've done plenty of those guys before.
I did plenty of those in the old days. I think it was a little bit faster than it's going to be tomorrow.
Yeah.
And it's a four-man season tomorrow, so I think I can keep up.
Okay, well, Nico's the man in charge. He's going to do a great job. We've got some other guys to catch up with.
What a good shit.
Hey, this is a tough job, but somebody's got to do it. Interviewing these two fine ladies, Deborah Shudra, Corey Plommer, and, the Steelers of the past, Deborah, they weren't just about the players, they were about the whole families, and it's good for you girls to get together again.
Definitely. To see Corey again and all the girls is just fantastic and great. Amazing.
Yeah? Well, it's made my weekend just seeing you two hug. Corey, when you walked into the arena, there was a tear in the eye. I don't think it's going to be the last tier, is it?
No, definitely not. No, Sheffield's a real special place for Tom and I, and it's nice for us to bring our children back and to meet people that are so dear to us and have made Sheffield such a special place for us. So it's wonderful, and I can't believe we're here.
Yeah.
It's very surreal. Yeah.
Well, it's good to have her here, isn't it, Deborah?
Oh, it's amazing. And you know, she's not changed a bit.
No, nobody has. Nobody has.
Have I? Just a little grayer. Yeah. Deborah, you've seen your husband's shirt race to the rafters. Tell Corey what the lump in the throat is going to be
like. Yeah, unbelievable. And I know it's going to be the same tomorrow because Tom's, you know.
I've got goosebumps thinking about it already just for him. I'm just happy for him because Sheffield is so special to him, really special to him. So.
Well, your two husbands have played a major part in the whole of the Sheffield Steelers. You still leave it, you still see it, Deborah.
Yeah, I mean, it's still as big and just the... You know, however, 20 years on, you know, just amazing the warmth you get from people, and you know, it's just not the same anywhere else.
You've got all this to come tomorrow because everybody's just going to grab Tommy, probably Cranny as well, and yourself, and it's going to be an emotional day.
Yes, it is going to be emotional for sure.
Yeah.
We went into Ice Sheffield just to have a look at it yesterday, and this fella just said to Tom, "Nice to see you back in Sheffield, Tommy." And it was just nice. It's just you wouldn't get that anywhere else, so it's really nice.
And you've got the kids here to see Dad's big
day. We've got the kids here, and it's a different lifestyle with having the kids around, but it's good. It's nice for us to show them where we lived. And we went up to our old house the other day and showed Olivia her first home, and it's just nice for them to put faces to names now, to see the people that we've talked about so often and so fondly of.
The standard of Sheffield Steelers play has always been great. The standards of Sheffield Steelers wives, well, they didn't get much better than these two. We can tell everybody's back. It's like everybody hasn't been away, isn't it, Cranny?
How long has it been, Dave?
Well, it must be 14, 15 for you.
Well, 12. 12 at least. Yeah? 12 at least. Yeah, no, really.
But when you walked in here tonight, it was like you'd been just gone for 6 months and then you come back and a summer away.
Yeah, no, time, you realize when you see everybody and all the stories.
He had to change in the hotel.
In the washroom. No, in the kitchen.
And he had his bag. He's like a bag man. That's basically what you are, a bag man.
Yeah, it is.
Why didn't you stay at the hotel?
Well, you two guys, you started in Durham.
Yeah.
Granny, you came to Sheffield first. Rick then took your spot after a little bit after that.
Don't go there, though, because that's probably the greatest team that ever played in England was our Durham team.
No. Our grandson team, no team.
Which team?
The team
So you're the 96 grandson. You're the 2001 Grand Slam.
There, that was by far the best team ever.
Which one?
2001.
No, Ricky. How can you rule us out, right?
Listen,
I wasn't there.
Everything.
I never lost. So I don't.
Yeah,
I don't.
Lose
yeah,
either,
I know. But so it's
Tim,
a bit
how many, Timmy, how many trophies do you have on the cabinet?
I don't know, Ricky. You're quite a lot.
Quite
how
a
about
few.
An Allen Cup?
Okay.
Yeah. How about that, big boy?
So we got Cowley in goal for 96. We got O'Neill in goal for 2001.
Both great goaltenders. I can't. Both great.
We got you leading the charge in 96. We got you leading the charge in 2001.
Yeah, but
no,
see,
I would
say
Lobby led the charge.
Lobby? Yeah.
Was he?
Yeah. Okay. And Lobby was one of your old pups.
Yeah, I love him. I found him in a little pit village on the moors. outside Whitley Bay. He's just a little bubby, like about that big. But I could tell, I could see his, you know, he was going to grow, and he kept growing. Look at him now. Look. Look at it. Look at that.
You know what it comes down to, Tim? Here. Different time, different era.
Yeah.
But the bottom line is, we had everything. You couldn't play us because we had three different lines that played three different styles.
Now, here's one guy. Let's just turn to Lobby a second.
Hey, what
here
is
we go.
The best team ever?
2001.
Yeah, by far, right?
By far.
David's the only
ever.
Guy, though. David's the only guy who can actually
David.
Tell the story because he played in 96
yeah.
and 2001.
Which one's a better team?
You really have to ask that?
Yes.
It's not even close.
The 2001?
Yes.
Holy crap.
Which one? What's he saying?
He went 2001.
No, but that's what they... Because I wasn't there. That's all they're saying that. I don't buy into that. I mean, no one would buy into that. Ask 10 people in this room.
Listen, that 2001 team is the best team that's ever been put on the ice in this country.
Yeah, I'll tell you, it's the best team in Britain. And for, you might be the best player ever to play in Britain.
You're
but that was the best team. So I don't care if you
would recommit to that.
2001
the best team you ever put together?
2001 the best team's ever been put together.
Yeah, by far.
Yeah, sorry, Cranley, but it's true.
I think I'm going to go with that. It's better than the British team 1995.
Yes. These are all, I was just hanging along with them. I was just only there because I mean good
they,
looks.
They said you were leading the charge.
Hey, not only the best looking
which
player.
Which I wouldn't doubt, right? Right, red face and all, right?
That's a damn. That's
grew up on fish and chips and Whitley Bay.
That's Steve.
He's the manager.
Oh, yeah. It was the best thing. I'm sorry, Cranny, but it was. It was.
Guys, right?
Hey, joined by two of the great Sheffield Steelers coaches, Mike Blaisdell, Alec Dampier, and damn sure tough job tomorrow. Might be keeping the big fella off the ice.
You know what? He looked good today. Honest to God, I thought he was like one of the best players out there. He's in great shape. I don't know what he's been doing, but he's about 20 pounds lighter than he was last time I saw him.
Blaisdell, welcome home.
Oh,
good to be back, eh?
Oh, it's great to be back. Yeah, yeah.
It's going to be a fun weekend. You're already having a good one.
Well, it's so good to see them. All the guys from the different, like the times. Like I keep trying to think that we all played together, but we didn't. We just kind of played for the Steelers, you know?
Yeah.
Like so it's kind of cool. Like, I always think that, and I look at the players and I go, well, you played with him, didn't you, on the Steelers? And they go, no, I didn't. I was a year behind him, but they're all getting along, so it's good.
Yeah, two Grand Slam winning coaches, yours in 96, and you got plenty of your old players back here this weekend.
Well, old is the word.
Yeah.
Yeah, there are lots of gray hair and lots of no hair. But a good bunch of guys, I'll tell you.
All in Tim Cranston's guys.
Well, yeah, I think he may have purchased some of that.
He said it's $100 a hair.
That's what he keeps saying, $100 a hair. Be careful, don't mess it up.
$200.
And Denny Vial back, part of your 2001 team.
Yeah, I know, it's so good to see him. And I heard him come in the room, that big laugh at Dennis's. And it's great to see him because he's such a... He was just such a key guy on that team, just his character. You know, he brought a lot of everything, toughness, skill, and toughness. Toughness and toughness.
Actually, I haven't seen Dennis since, I think we had a bit of a mishap in Nottingham, wasn't it?
You saw a lot of him that night.
Did we? Did see a fair bit of him, yeah. Some guys took that so personal.
You two were on opposite ends on that great day. We had a good laugh that day. It was fun.
Oh, frick.
Yeah, we went out there.
Yeah, we went out there.
I was glad I wasn't out there. That looked dangerous out there.
Yeah, I did.
I can remember Mike that night going, look at Metcalf fighting. And then he go, oh, no, look at the goalie fighting. We were just going up and down the bench.
Yeah, no, that was a good one.
Good fun. Yeah. It's going to be fun tomorrow as well, isn't it?
It's going to be, it's going to be a good laugh. You know, the guys that I haven't met or haven't worked with, they're all great guys. You know, talk about Dennis Vial. What a lovely gentleman, you know, great fella.
Yeah. Mike, looking forward to playing as well.
Yeah, no, just because I played with a lot of these guys earlier, like Rick, and then played against Tony Han and played against Lobby, and then never really played with Lobby, a couple shifts maybe. But anyways, it's kind of, I'm looking forward to it. It'll be fun. Yeah.
Okay, it's great to see you two guys back. Good luck tomorrow.
Thanks, David.
A great night for the legends to catch up before the big day. The following morning, some were a little more eager than others to get back on the ice.
I'm getting a little bit of cheat time in.
It's three times bigger than Tommy, for God's sake.
They were going to make a life-size manor at Tommy, but he wasn't big enough.
Same
size as Steve.
Yeah.
Up to the arena, see?
Thank you. Cheers, boys.
How's it?
Out of shape. Out of shape.
Is it going to be tough later?
Yeah. I'll be good for maybe one shift.
I'm just wondering whether that's...
Yeah, let's go, we'll go with that. Okay. One shift a period, Max.
Well, there's enough of you to go at.
Yeah, I think that's all we're going to be able to fit in.
Mike, welcome back to Sheffield. I think it's going to be an entertaining but an enjoyable day for everybody, isn't it?
Yeah, I'm sure it is. You know, a lot of good characters come back, and it's a good way to celebrate 20 years of Steeler hockey and, you know, support Tony Smith in launching a new season.
Yeah, a lot of characters. I see Plommer, Vial, Kellen just over your shoulder there. There's been a few characters that have walked down this this corridor, and that's been one of the successes of the club, hasn't it?
Oh, yeah. You know what? You look over the years, the number of great people that have played here. And you know, the success the team, the, you know, the club has enjoyed, and I think today is a celebration of that.
Yeah. First shift, it's going to take the wind out of you.
First shift, the warm up will.
I don't think there is a warm up. I think it's just a 2 minute skate just beforehand. People like Dennis though, they can only play one way, can't they? I think some guys will perhaps take it a bit more serious than others.
Well, I'm sure you know Cranny and you know those guys will be fired up, but. You know, I think today is about getting through and making it back to the dressing room in one piece.
Okay, enjoy your day.
Thanks a lot, Dave.
General, welcome home. You had a good night last night, everybody did, and this whole weekend's been a good social, a good fun, but now a little bit of serious hockey.
Well, I don't know if it's going to be real serious hockey, but hopefully
Dennis thinks it is.
Well, Dennis thinks everything's serious when you regard the hockey. Him and Brebant are probably going 100 miles an hour. Take care of guys like me that are only going 50 miles an hour.
Has the last 24 hours brought some good memories back, being around the guys again?
Oh, lots of good memories. Sheffield's my home now. I was welcomed here by the people when I first came, and it's good to welcome them back now to Sheffield. It's good to see a lot of the old guys back.
Yeah, Plummer, big day for the Duke, isn't it? It's having his shirt raised into the rafters, and he's as proud as Punch standing back there.
Yeah, a massive day for the Duke, and he deserves it. He put a lot of effort into Sheffield. He was a young guy, spent his mid-20s here, and he's getting a little bit back for it now, and he deserves it.
Just from an outsider's point of view, what did Sheffield do right, Chris, that got all these people together? Not just in the stands, but the great characters in the team.
Well, I think they had some good people recruiting hockey players. Hockey players are willing to come to the city and get involved in the city. We went out and did a lot of things with the police, drug freeze into schools and things like that. You get young people interested in coming to the arena, they bring their mom and dads. And well, I mean, we had a full rink here for a long time. A few things happened here and there that maybe were a bit dodgy, but... hopefully they can get a good team going again here again this year and get the crowds back again.
Okay, enjoy your day.
Thank you very much.
Alex, welcome back. What's it like to be back?
It's been really good to see a lot of the fellas. And, you know, I knew most of them and... even the ones I hadn't coached or coached against, they're a good bunch of lads. We're having a lot of fun.
What about your memories? Because you spent so much time here. It was, in a way, your last club.
You know what, and Mike Blaisdell and I were talking about it. It's one of the best places to play. It was so much fun, the acceptance of the town. Yeah, I couldn't have thought of a better place to play in the country.
Any abiding memories, any particular memories spring to mind?
Not really. I think probably the first time we'd won a trophy, we came back to the rink at about, I think it was 1 a.m, and the parking lot was full. There must have been 6,000 or 7,000 people waiting for us, and that really shocked everybody. Especially Mike O'Connor.
Getting goosed by Mike O'Connor. That's a memory.
Well, it brings back memories also.
And of course, you had a dual role. You were GB coach and Steelers coach at the same time.
Yeah. It was a busy time. And again, I have to thank George Dodds, who's the owner, allowed me to take on both roles because it did take away from Sheffield at times.
Is there something special about the Steelers? If you were able to bottle it, what would it be?
You know, I think at the time, the ownership got the players into the community, and you know, there was probably three days a week they were amongst the community somewhere, and I think that was the big thing. It just guys became part and parcel of Sheffield.
How did you manage to pick up so many good imports? Because you did, your scouting session was really good.
Well, Dave Sims had a big part of that. We were very busy, and Dave took on a role of finding agents, and you know, took that off our plate. You know, eventually we had to go look at them and view the players, but David did a lot of legwork for us.
Is it hard to name the best import that you played with or had under yourself?
You know, there was lots of good ones, and it'd really be unfair to name just one. There was just a ton of good guys that came over here, and not just good players, they were good characters. I'm sure you remember a lot of them were just great fellas to go have a pint with, and you weren't ashamed to take them home. You know, they're just genuine nice fellas.
How quickly did they accept you here? Because you were a Panthers coach before you came here. Was that transition difficult?
It wasn't hard because we were in first division, and there was no rivalry between Sheffield. So it was the following year when we made it up into the Premier League, I think it was called. Then the rivalry started, and really, Sheffield fans, all they want to do is beat Nottingham.
What are you thinking about today? There'll be a few tired limbs out there?
Yeah, a lot of the guys don't play at all anymore. You know, they haven't, like Chris Kellen said, he hasn't skated in 10 years. So it'll be interesting. But there are a few guys who still keep in shape and still play.
Not seeing Alex Dampier out on the ice today?
I'd love to be, but old age and an injury holds me back. That's my excuse.
I missed you last night, bud. I wish you would come over. What a laugh.
Seriously?
Oh, what a laugh. Just the craziest talks. We had a crazy laugh.
Oh, it's not you. Tony, yeah, they talk about big transfers in football, but actually you coming to the Steelers at the time was a big story.
I think, well, at the time it was, because I'd played all my career in Edinburgh and decided to make a huge move to Steelers, which I had here 4 years, which I thoroughly enjoyed. And I say I had a great time here.
What was it that attracted you to come from Murrayfield to here?
Steelers was such a big name. There's a huge fan base. There were quality players in the organisation anyway. Alex Dampier here is the coach. So there's a lot of players and people that I've been worked with in the past who were here. So it was great.
And how easy was it to fit in?
It was quite easy, to be honest with you, because they had such a good team at the time. So like you say, if it wasn't like I was coming to one of the bottom place team and trying to pull them up the ladder, they were already at the top. So it was good to come here.
And who was your favourite partner up front?
There was a few. There's a few good players here. Probably far too many to mention offhand. But I just thought it was a great team in all.
Yeah. And this place, now you walk back in here, I know you've been here a few times, but does it bring back those great memories?
Yeah, I always like coming back to Sheffield and playing and seeing the place. Because, as you say, we had great success here as a team. And it's always nice to come back. And it's nice to see all the old faces, that guys you haven't seen for years.
Before the legends took to the ice, the Steelers of tomorrow had their big moment under the spotlight. We saw the juniors 10s, 12s, 14s, 16s and 18s take on their Cardiff counterparts. We caught up with Ron Shudra on the back of his side's 12-0 win.
It is an exhibition sort of thing, and you know, it's all about the kids coming up and playing and having a bit of ice time and getting them to work a bit harder. And you know, you never want to see scores that are high, but you know, it happens in games, and then kids will just learn from it and go and get better for the next time.
I guess it comes down to the coaching.
No, not to do with the coaching. It's all about the players.
Yeah.
It's always the players, never the coaches, right?
Are you looking forward to the rest of the day?
Yeah, it should be a great day. The kids
will enjoy themselves. The old guys, us old timers, we'll enjoy ourselves for sure. And you know, and then to cap it off with the big boys coming out to play, and hopefully the real entertainment is then.
Definitely. Are you looking forward to seeing the rest of the legends?
Yeah, I mean, it's been great to see all the guys. You know, just catching up and seeing everybody and having a chat and you know, being back in the same room. And you know, you're joking with the coaches before, you know, with Alex and Blaise, and you guys turn around and you go, wouldn't it be nice to have this lineup as a team way back then? And it was like, yeah, it was. So, you know, it's great for them to have that experience again.
Back in the locker room, the players were starting to get kisses up ahead of their big game.
Some shooting drills starting off.
Good with the hands.
Jesus Christ, Haggis, is that your foot or somebody else? That's worse than yesterday. You gotta go to the hospital, man.
I'll go after the game.
Go
after the game. Hey, this is the last time I get.
Bad, I got badly.
Go see Dr. Butcher right now.
Is the doc here?
Sir, no drug tests, Cranny. We're good.
Okay.
We're good.
But no, I've had some painkillers. All right. Don't want to miss this, do I?
I got those here. Willie. Look. Mine are just... I just feel awkward without them. But mine are just... Blazer, in 96, were you the player coach in Nottingham?
A little bit, maybe. I don't know. We're starting... Yeah, I played the first half of the year. And then I stupidly brought in the guy that replaced me. Belanger. Remember?
Look at the arena for the legends. Who are you looking forward to see?
Tim Cranston, of course.
How about yourself?
Longstaff. The first shirt.
Tony Hand.
Yeah. Tim Cranston. It's my shirt since I was five.
And how long have you been following the Steelers?
Since I was five.
Yeah. Well, more than that. About 19
years.
Not quite the first time. Not the first year. Came after that.
Yeah, is it going to be funny to see them all bike together again?
Oh, that's going to be great, absolutely.
Yeah. Just hope they're able to move around the ice enough.
Maybe
some
shift.
Of them look like they've put a bit of weight on.
Timmy Cranston.
Yeah, he's down there.
Yeah.
Plommer.
Yeah.
Brennan.
And how long have you been following the Steelers?
Nearly 20 years. Nearly the full time.
Yeah, can you ever see 95 shirt?
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. You are going to have one hell of an afternoon. Before we see the legends that have built our foundations, how about the guys who want to be the next generation of Sheffield Steelers legends? Sheffield, to get into the spirit, will you please welcome, first of all, the Sheffield under-12s. Following the under-12s, their big brothers, the under-14s. As the under-14s walk around, there's a young Shudra in the making. You'll see his dad in a few moments' time. What about their big brothers, the under-16s? The 16s have brothers, the under-18s, the next generation of Sheffield Steelers. But Sheffield, would you please put your hands together? Welcome to Sheffield, the 12s, the 14s, the 16s, the 18s, and the girls, as we ask them to leave the ice. Sheffield, have you got handkerchiefs? Some of you are going to need them.
5, 4, 3.
Arena, tremendous.
tremendous atmosphere here for the Steelers. Last game of the 1991-1992 season. The Steelers tonight require just 1 point to ensure that they are the team in Heineken Division 1 next season. Blue skate to Steve Nimmoth. White one up. Oh!
I'll tell you, the fans are number one. Here we are tonight. We showed them, and it was great.
You know, we got to go out there and next season and do the same thing. If we can do it, hopefully, then we'll be very successful.
Team, a legends team, is too big a job for one man. So ladies and gentlemen, you please welcome back to Sheffield a man who in the early days helped us so much at BBC Radio Sheffield, from BBC Five Live, Mr. Bob Ballard.
We had so many great nights, and I hope you all enjoyed it. You're going to enjoy this afternoon. There are some people who look exactly the same, pretty much, as they did 10 years ago. I can't believe how some people have worked. In fact, I don't think we weathered as well as they have.
I don't think we have. Then again, Bob, neither you nor I have had a hair transplant.
Who are we talking about?
And one of the Sheffield Steelers legends has.
Are we going to mention names?
I don't think we'll mention names, but it'll be the last guy out.
TC? Oh, sorry.
Ladies and gentlemen, the summer of 2011 wouldn't be the summer without trial and tribulation, would it? And of course, the Sheffield Steelers arrive here in August on this bank holiday with a new owner, Tony Smith, and the Smith family in charge of our club. But Sheffield, the first person I would like to introduce out to you was the man who brought hockey to Sheffield some 20 years ago. Ladies and gentlemen, the very first Sheffield Steelers owner, please welcome home George Dodds.
Well, here we are, 20 years on. Could you imagine, could you have imagined when you started all this off that this is what would happen?
I didn't imagine that, but I did intend it, so I'm very happy you are here.
What was the plan? What were your thoughts when you started off the Steelers in 91?
If I have to be honest, and I think I should be today, I thought I was going to make some money out of it. However, Sheffield, you took something like 50 or 60 K a year off me, so congratulations.
Very quickly, what was it like, though, the match against Cardiff, the match against Nottingham, to have 12,000 people in this arena?
The atmosphere was fantastic, but I was saying to my wife on the way here, if your heart's in your team, you're just so nervous. You just want only one result. You want to win. And sometimes it's nicer not to be affiliated to either team and watch the hockey, because the hockey was absolutely amazing.
And thanks to you, we have what we have now. George Sods, thank you very much indeed.
Your first GM, all the way from South Africa, Ronnie Woods.
Your magic's still there. Ronnie, how and why did you buy into this project?
Only for the money.
Yeah, well, that would be typical. I believe you even said that. But no, seriously, when this was put to you, when the idea first came up, what was it attracted you to it?
I think it was the challenge. That was pretty much it. Just to fill this place and prove all the doubters that they were wrong, that they said it couldn't happen. And we made it happen.
What obstacles did you have to overcome in the early days to make it happen?
Awareness of the sport pretty much on a national basis. But the local population were fantastic, and the media were 100% behind us, so I don't think we were ever going to fail.
Similar question to what I put to George a few minutes ago. When this building was full, it was rocking, how did you feel that you created something like that?
I think many times you don't notice because you're playing, but you know, when you look back on it in hindsight, it was breathtaking. I've traveled the world, I've been to many arenas, watched many championships, and nothing has emulated the atmosphere that was generated here. So I think it's unique, and it will always be unique, and I don't think it's ever going to be matched anywhere, to be honest.
Ronnie, welcome home, because this is your home.
It's on the blue line. On the blue line.
Say hello and welcome to Sir Alex Dampier.
What a reception. Well done. I mean, it's like old times, isn't it?
Yeah, it's wonderful to be back, I tell you. It's been a real hoot. A few late nights, mind you, but it's been good.
This man, I've known him for about 20 years, has not changed a bit. Has he? Look at him now.
Well, beside you, maybe. But.
Yeah, that's true. Everybody's changed beside me. Now, dare I mention it, you came from the enemy down the road. Was there any reaction to that? Any hostility towards that?
Who's down the road?
That a boy, Dan. Well,
no, it was great when we came here. I mean, this is a real turning point for me in Britain. When we first came here, it was just amazing. The fans were just fantastic, and you know, I couldn't have thought of a better place to play.
At that time, you were also a GB coach, you're trying to do two jobs. Was that difficult being Sheffield Steelers coach and in charge of GB at the same time?
You know, it had its challenges, but we were very fortunate. George Dodds, the owner, allowed me to do both because it did distract from the Steelers at times, but we had a good support group here, so when I was away, things worked very smoothly, probably better.
And your best memory of the Steelers, would it be one that you'll take to your grave?
My grave?
It's a long way off here.
Yeah, I think the night we won one of the first championships, we came back to the arena about, it was probably 1 a.m, and there was, I think, around 6,000 people waiting. That was... That's when I knew that we really had something going here in Sheffield.
And you're back. Welcome back. Good to see you again.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 1996 Grand Slam goalie. Party on Sheffield. Party on Wayne. Wayne's World. Wayne Cowley.
That is now confirmed for me, as if it needed confirming, Wayne, that goalies do have a screw loose, do they not?
So they say. I try to believe I'm not one of those guys, but...
What did you think about the standard of the hockey when you were here?
I came in and I guess it was game two of the Benson and Hedges, I think, the first cup that we won. And the game, I think we almost lost that game, which wouldn't allow us to get the triple, but the caliber was great, and it was a great year for us and a great year for Sheffield.
It's great to have you back. Thanks for your contribution.
Oh, thanks for having me.
Wayne Cowley.
ladies and gentlemen, the General, Chris Kelland.
Well, I've got to say, earlier on you told me you have not skated for how long?
11 years.
11 years. Looked like that was like time going backwards.
I hope it goes backwards fast today.
Now listen, you stuck around quite a few of the, obviously you became a GB national anyway, but a lot of the people went home, went back to Canada or to America. You stayed around in Sheffield. Why was that?
When I first came to Sheffield, the people welcomed me. I enjoyed it here. I met a British girl and had to get a real job and stayed.
And a bit like, we'll talk to Tony later on about Murrayfield to here. What persuaded you to come and play for the Steelers?
Well, I went to Nottingham first, and that's not a friendly place, so I decided to come to Sheffield.
And your favourite memory? You had so many good years here. Was it one abiding memory that you'll take back with you?
Just probably the year with the Grand Slam was probably the biggest year for me, probably in all my career.
Chris Kelland, everybody, a legend.
Sheffield, when he left the club, we never had a chance to say goodbye. We never had a chance to say thank you. So please join me in doing it now for Mike O'Connor.
Ooh, good to see you back on skates again.
Well, a little bit dodgy coming out of the gate there.
You were part of two great hockey dynasties in this country, Durham Wasps and Sheffield Steelers. How do they compare?
Well, you know what? I really had a great time in Durham. You know what? It was a great place to play, but coming to Sheffield, it was such a big club, and, you know, the place was fanatical about hockey, so it was fantastic.
Wasn't it amazing how quickly Sheffield took to hockey as well? It wasn't like a 4 or 5 year thing. It happened almost overnight.
Yeah, I could remember opening the building with Mike Blaisdell and Rick Brebent when we played in Durham, and we thought it'd never work in this city, you know, not with all the professional sports. But, you know, here we are today, 20 years later, and, you know, going strength to strength.
You've done pretty much every job with the Sheffield Steelers. Is there one special moment or one special thing that you look back on your career for?
Well, I think, you know, the time that I finished my career here, you know, playing with you know, some of the all-time legends like, you know, Cranston and Plummer and Tony Hand and Cowley, you know, those are fantastic moments.
Yeah, and they're memories that you'll take forever, aren't they?
Absolutely.
Mike O'Connor, everybody.
I'll say three words to you, or maybe just one word. Andre, Andre, Andre Marlowe.
Andre, welcome back. Good to see you again. That 95-96 vintage is probably the best British hockey team ever.
Yeah, it was very good. I think we had a great team, great spirit in the dressing room, some great characters, and it was a great year that year.
Why was the chemistry so good? I mean, I know Alex put it together, but what was it about that team that made them so special?
Well, we just had, like, you know, obviously we had our scorers, the guys who were quite talented. We also had our grinders, the guys who could go out and do the work, you know, in the corners and all that. Great D, great goaltending. So. Good recipe for success.
Everybody remembers your wrist shot. They remember how powerful it was. Did Alex have to say to you, you know, leave it to the boys up front? That's not a D-man's job.
No. Remember that if you can get up there and, you know, have a go at shooting the puck and all that, and just go for it.
What's it like to be back today?
Great. Great to see the guys and obviously the fans in Sheffield. Great night last night. Great banter. Good to be in the dressing room again. The jokes flying in and all that, so it's great fun.
Andre, good to see you again. Andre Marlowe.
Ladies and gentlemen, one of the true Sheffield Steelers characters and legends, welcome home, Rob Wilson.
It's a great response today, isn't it?
Yeah, it's fantastic. It's great to be back, and we had a great time
together last night, seeing everybody, and talked a lot of times about the good times and a lot of stories and a lot of laughs. And that's what it was. It was just a great time.
When we talk about big matches and matches that you remember most, obviously we don't have Wembley anymore. Was Wembley special for you?
Well, I think the whole mystique of Wembley was special. You know, when you look at what it was, and you know what, we were lucky to be part of that. You know, when you think back of it now, and Wembley was just such a great time, and it had that that great aura about it, and we had such a great group of guys, and it was a really good time.
You say lucky, but a lot of the luck has to be made by the players and by the coaching staff. How was it you got such a, you know, it didn't seem like you had any parts of that team that didn't work. Every little piece of the jigsaw fitted into place really well.
Well, I didn't say we were lucky on the ice. I said we're just lucky that we were together. But no, you know, it did. It, you know, the players that were picked for that team, everyone had a certain role, and everyone worked really well together. And like I said, we were talking about last night, Damps and I were talking about the camaraderie between everybody and the friendships, and everyone just had a certain piece that fit in the puzzle.
Quick word about what you're doing now. You're working in Italy. How's your Italian?
Not very good. Not very good. A little bit better than my English, but it's coming. Actually, it's more German there, so I'm trying to learn German.
Okay, good luck with both of those. Rob Wilson.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome home Big Neil Abel.
Years and years ago, you'll remember this, we used to have a rotor for the ice line, and Neil used to say, oh, get me off it. Every week, I see Neil's name on it. Is he going to turn up this week, or is he going to try and swap with somebody? You never really enjoyed doing that all that much, did you?
No, I only ever enjoyed going when Ron was going, because he'd done all the speaking, and I just sat there and done nothing.
And also, it was the case that I always wanted to speak to Ron and never ask you any questions.
Well, that's because I would never answer anyways.
Sheffield experience, what's it been like for you?
Oh, it's been excellent. It's been like a great bunch of guys. It's great being back here again. Last year, winning the league, back here again. Another excellent set of guys, and hopefully we can do exactly the same, if not better.
Now, you've seen it from both sides, playing side and coaching side. Which is easier?
Playing side.
Really?
Yeah, you don't have to put up with moaning players coming on and like just growling at you and everything like that. So.
Prospects for this year, now you're number two here?
Silverware, that's what we need here. So that's first and foremost.
Optimistic?
I'm quite confident that we can lift some silverware again this year.
Looking forward to seeing you play again later as well.
I don't think about that much.
Neil Abel, everybody.
It makes us proud to welcome home the Dancing Bear, the captain of the 2001 Grand Slam team, Dennis Vial.
Listen, I'm amazed you achieved what you achieved in that year with what was going on behind the scenes. How did you do it?
You know what? We just had a great locker room. Like Dave says, I think that was probably the best team ever assembled as far as character and keeping the guys focused when it came to play. And when the guys, when the time lights up the skates, everyone had a job to do, and we all did it.
Was it a case of a siege mentality that, you know, everybody was against you, people outside you were against you, so kind of everything within was working well?
Well, yeah, but you know what? The fans were great, though. I mean, it probably came out in the light near the end of the season. I think fans kind of caught on what might have been happening. But you know what, though? They stuck behind us, and when we go into the locker room, guys, and we just said, you know what? Goes, if you know, if we're gonna win, we win for ourselves and win for the fans, and then the other stuff will take care of itself.
Yeah, that's worth a round of applause. We heard Tim Cranston talking about how '96 was the best team and how 2001, in your opinion, is the best team. What were the things about the 2001 team that makes it the best team, do you think?
I think it was just the well-orchestrated, best chemistry team put together. I mean, we could answer the bell in any way. I mean, for skill, talent, toughness. You know, we played games with a lot of injuries, and it just, when you look at the whole season and when you just put it all together, like, I think anybody's mind is probably the most well put together club. And of all the years I played hockey, I think it's by far the best club put together.
Any regrets that you weren't here longer?
Yeah, well, you know what? I mean, after a couple of years, I kind of missed it here. And I just kind of looking, but it just, I was pretty close to finishing playing hockey. And I just didn't want to continue anymore. But I you know what? I look back now, I wish I played longer here. I really do.
And a quick word about the reception you just got from these people here.
I'm sorry?
Quick word about the reception you've just received from the people here.
I'm honored. I mean, like, first of all, I'm honored even Dave since I'd be invited. I didn't think, I didn't know if anyone even liked me anymore. I don't know. So so when I get the phone call, and I mean, I was honored. I said, you know what, Dave, I'll come. I mean, the past is past. And I mean, I know Dave and I have butted heads, and even Mike Blaisdell. And, you know, I was honored when Mike Blaisdell put me on his, when he had to put his last this team together. And I was on that team. So I was, and I mean, the fans here, I mean, they're great. I mean, I can't, they're probably one of the best fans in the world. They really are. Loyalty and everything.
They're really happy to have you back. We are too. Dennis, thank you very much indeed. Dennis Vial.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome home, Timo Wilman.
Timo, welcome back. Great reception from the crowd here. What's your favourite memories of the Sheffield Steelers?
Well, two victories, of course. Double winning, eh? That was the best.
And the team that you played on, tell us about some of the characters, some of the players on that team.
Oh, yeah, we have lots of characters. Dion Darling, yeah, all kind of guys. So we have a great bunch of guys.
How did you come here? When I imagine Dave made the phone call to you. How did he sell the Sheffield Steelers to you?
Well, actually, it wasn't Dave. It wasn't Dave. It was actually Mike himself. And well, they told me it's the best place in England, so it was hard to refuse.
Is there any reason, do you think, certainly when the Steelers started, they had a few Swedish players the first couple of years. Is there any reason why there haven't been more Scandinavian players coming here?
I don't know. Ask Dave.
Is it you're too expensive?
I don't know. Ask Dave.
He does some negotiations, Timo. Thank you very much indeed.
Rockets, Ron Shudra.
When I went to the Hockey Hall of Fame, I expected to see your hair in there for some reason. I thought that this going to hit. It's been transplanted. Hello.
Hello.
Yeah. You'll be as talkative as Dad in a few years' time. I'm not sure whether it's left for me to ask you. I think I've asked you every question over the years. So tell me about the legacy of the Sheffield Steelers. You've been associated with this for the best part of 20 years.
Well, you know, it's something here that is very, very special in Sheffield. You know, we've had a lot of great times, and great times obviously will still be ahead of us as a club and as a bunch of, as we say, David's family members. So, you know, it's a great thing. It's put a lot of young players out on the ice. We've seen a couple here today on the ice that have the ability to go on to better things, and that's what the game is all about, especially here in Sheffield. We want to develop everybody and get them to have some fun and play like we did.
You've had an awful lot of good times, some hard times here as well, haven't they? It hasn't all been plain sailing.
Well, no, but hey, it wouldn't be Sheffield if it was easy, would it? You know, why make it easy on ourselves? Go out and you know, we all keep coming back. You know, the guys, it's a credit all the guys that have been here in the past and the guys, again, that are going to be here in the future to see what a facility and what it's like to play here in Sheffield for a team like this.
What's it like being back with the guys again?
Oh, it's great. You know, you listen about some of the stories and you just go, oh my God, were we actually around for all these stories?
Do you remember those stories, or have they made them up?
No, they're all true. Believe me, some of them you can't actually say in public, which is probably a good thing. But you know, it's wonderful to see everybody back in town. I'm sure they're gonna go out and have a lot of fun this weekend and enjoy themselves, which is what everybody wants to do.
Do you have a clean story you want to tell the public?
No.
No? None at all?
Oh, no, I don't have...
I'm sure you do. Don't you want to hear a story from Shudra?
There are no stories.
Come on, you're going to be behind me on this one. No stories from Shudra?
I don't remember any stories.
I do.
It's a lot about you.
The mind is gone. I'm that old.
He is the bedrock, the fulcrum of the Sheffield Seers. Call him what you are. He's a very special man. Ron Shudra.
Ladies and gentlemen, an absolute gentleman and a credit. Please welcome home, Bobby Saunders.
Tell us about those early days, because a lot of the guys we spoke to came in sort of 93, 94. You were here from the outset.
Yes, that's right. It was seems a long time ago now, but it's, well, what can I say? It was an absolutely fantastic time, and the whole start of the Steelers, really. And a whirlwind of an experience.
And you saw the crowd go from like 1,000, 2,000, 3,000 up to about 6 or 7 in the space of about 18 months.
Yeah, I mean, I remember at Christmas, we had 11,000, didn't we? And we had all the seats around the back of there. I mean, it was a crazy, crazy time, really. Absolutely amazing. Never forget those days.
What was it like to play in front of that? Because, I mean, most of the time up to that stage, you've been playing down the road in front of maybe about 20 or 30 people, and you're playing in front of 10,000 people.
Yeah, well, we went from playing at Queen's Road, where there was 150 people, if you were lucky, if there was a disco on after, to, like I say, 11,000 people. It was just a dream, absolute dream. It was a, you know, boyhood dream, and, you know, I'll never forget that.
First time you stepped on the ice here, what were your thoughts? You're looking around at the seats, you've got a 60 by 30 ice you've never played on before.
Well, I just thought it was too big. and it lit. It had lighting in it. We never had lighting down at Queen's Road in those days, so it was just amazing. Absolutely. It was just like, you know, proper hockey rink. Proper hockey rink in Sheffield. Unbelievable.
Did it seem like 20 years ago?
It did yesterday when I had a skate, but now it's just a blink of the eye. Absolute blink of the eye now. But it's good to be here. It's absolutely fantastic. The crowd's unbelievable. It's really good.
Great to see you back, Robbie. Thanks for coming.
Ladies and gentlemen, one of the true characters of this world, please welcome our Haggis, Alan Hay.
People are just the best. It's good to be home. It's just, this is the place for hockey.
What is it about this place that you can go to the rear end up and down? There's some special magic about this. And you've played here, you've seen it around. What is it about this place?
Sheffield people. Sheffield people are the best. I just love the city. I was born here, I was born 5 miles away. I support the greatest football team in the world. I know so. Pardon?
Which is?
United. And of course, I always support the greatest hockey team, the Steelers.
Is there a Tim Cranston who turns off at any time, switches off at any time?
Well, I haven't slept since the early 80s. But, anyways, hello everyone. Thanks for coming out. Love you guys. Get this show on the road. Hopefully, Kurt will show up and take the meeting.
That's seriously. It was the intensity of people all the time. The enthusiasm of the game. You never seen him on off day. Always on.
Well, I don't know about that one, but it's just part of coming to play and part of what we all try to do here. And it was not taking the night off, right? So that's what it was all about.
Also taken to the ice with Mark Lefebvre, Nick Rothwell, Les Milley, David Longstaff, Tony Hamm, Jason Lafrenier, Rick Brabant, Mike Perron, Mike Blaisdell, well, after the long journey, a few weary Devils making their way onto the ice. The Steelers led out by Wayne Cowley. A locker room that's had plenty of laughs and smiles so far. But there will be a few serious faces, I think, throughout the course of this game, but certainly not Ron Shudra. A lot of these players will enjoy every single moment of this trip, including Jason Lafrenier. That word is, he's already had a few good nights in Sheffield, reminiscing. Pre-game smiles then. Will it still be like this after two periods of hockey, though? Some really competitive characters out there. Well, here we go then. The Legends game about to get underway. And the Steelers go with the Cranston, Plommer and Milley line. And of course, Turbo Tim wins that first face-off. So Steelers in the white jerseys, it's the Devils in the red jerseys. Here is Cranston in the zone, trying to work something out. Interception, and now Ruggles will bring it back the other way. Tripping over the blue line, I'm not sure what that's all about.
That's cool.
A bit of diligence from Alex Dampier. Just checking he's got his lines right. So Longstaff out there with Blaisdell and Brabant. Rick Brabant, of course, played for both these two sides, as did Vesio Sacratini. Good interception by the Steelers, breaking into the zone. This could be a real opportunity to create something with Timo Wilman. That's a good save lowdown.
Hey, Tony, still got that tap for the stick here. Yeah, I just heard
it. The banter is merciless in that locker room. Chance for the Devils then. That's wide of the target. Cowley deals with that one comfortably. This could be a chance to break for the Steelers. Hand. Still got it, hasn't he? Opportunity out in front is Neil Abel. Well, of all the legends, big Neil Abel puts the Steelers on the board. I don't think even he can quite believe it. No penalty. Can't be a penalty, despite the floppy legs of John Lawless. David Longstaff, always one of the worst when it comes to taking the mickey out of the other players. He was like that as well when he played. Here come the Devils. This could be an opportunity for them. Steelers, though, trying to defend this one resolutely. Cardiff still build. Cowley, can he make the save? Not on this occasion. And it's Vezio Sacratini, so often the thorn in the Steelers' side, who levels things up here. High fives all round. One apiece and on level terms. Will that get the juices flowing here?
Surprisingly, there's a bit of a pace. For old guys.
Well, Alex is impressed.
Everybody used to do that.
Oh, yeah, we're going.
Tony!
Good save low down from Cowley. Still, the Devils are pressing here, though. Now the Steelers can try and break away. Good stretch pass. Now here's Hand. This is a real opportunity. Tony Hand! Oh, no! They're going to get a shake of the head, surely. Alan Haig, one of the original Sheffield Steelers, getting a bit of stick from the bench as the Steelers come forward again. This could be a good opportunity. Oh, is it going to be finished? It is. The Steelers eventually getting the goal. David Longstaff on the doorstep, scored those so many times during his career at the House of Steel, along with Rick Brabant. Mike Blaisdell put David Longstaff alongside Jason Weaver, and they were one of the most outstanding lines in the league when the Steelers won the Grand Slam back in 2001. Blaisdell now taking a position on that line himself in place of Weaver. Wilman plays the puck out of the zone. Steelers will now try and move up the centre of the ice. It's with Brabant. This is the chance. Oh, he scores! Well, left unchecked. Rick Brabant rolls back the years with that strike. One to enjoy. So back-to-back goals for the Sheffield Steelers, and they bring out a 3-1 lead, and there could be more here. Steelers with a chance with Blaisdell. Now Longstaff. This line really picking up the pace here. Another opportunity. Oh, it's another goal! Neil Abel with his second of the game. And of course, there's big smiles all around. Neil Abel has just equaled his best ever season for the club. Into the second period then. Steelers up by 4-1. Face-off win. That's a tip, and Tommy Plummer scores! Well, that's going to be a popular one. Here's Brabant. Tries to go down low. Steelers trying to put pressure on. They've got a 4-goal advantage here. Now possibly an opportunity at the back door. Shot well saved. Still the Steelers with the pressure, though. Maybe they should give it to Neil Abel. He's the hot hand right now. Another chance down low for the Steelers to try and create something here. Another shot goes in. Rebound pops out again, and the Steelers are there on the rebound. Another goal scored. And David Longstaff, I think, will get the credit for this one. No! 6-1 then. The Steelers legends really putting in a performance here, but there's a bit of danger. This could be a chance. Oh, no opportunity to stop that one. Vezio Sacratini with his second of the game. Here are the Devils again then, looking to cut the deficit in half. That's a first save, but the second rebound was too easy for the Devils. And Rob Wilson, well, all smiles. I can assure you, 15 years ago, he would have been smashing that stick up on the bench. As the Devils do cut it in half, and the Steelers got to do a bit of defensive work here. Maybe now they can break away. It's with Marlow, still Andre Marlow, the ball! Shoots and scores! Andre Marlow! 7-3 Steelers. Well, time ticking down then in this one. Fans are on their feet. We've been royally entertained by these veterans of the game. Some superb players out there. Maybe one last chance, good save. Well, that was the opportunity. And the final hooter will blow momentarily. So the Steelers legends victorious in this one. Final goal coming from that man, Andre Marlowe. But there were moments, particularly in that first period, that really did show some of the best of these players. And Tommy Plummer will have his shirt retired a little later on. Well, Vezio Sacratini with two goals will pick up the case of beer for the Devils. For the Steelers, it might well be his first man of the match performance in a Sheffield Steelers shirt. Neil Abel with two goals. Picks it up from Sir Alex Dampier. Well, what a game. Well, these players off to go and enjoy the refreshments in the locker room then. Before the start of the friendly between the current Steelers squad and the Devils, another famous number was retired in Sheffield. After playing eight seasons with the Steelers between 1992 and 2000, it was time to retire the number 11 shirt of Steelers legend Tommy Plummer.
Tommy, rolling back the years today, how did it feel?
You know what, it felt pretty good out there, and it was great to be out there. It was a nice atmosphere, great, some real great hockey players, some great memories, but we knew it was just for fun. And you could tell, and it was enjoyable, and I've looked forward to that for a long time, and it was a nice touch. You know, I never thought I would have the opportunity to play here again.
What did it feel like when you stepped back on the ice for the first time?
You know what? When I was here, I was here for a long time, and it feels so comfortable. It feels like yesterday. You know, it doesn't seem that long ago, but I know 10 years has passed, and the reason you can tell usually is you see the kids growing up a little bit. You know, but other than that, everyone looks the same. And it felt the same, you know, it felt really good, real comfortable.
What do you think about the reception you got from the crowd today?
Oh, it's always been good, you know. I've always been very thankful to them and very appreciative, and I couldn't say enough about them. They've always been great to me, and I'll remember that always.
Did you feel the old camaraderie coming back? Was it like clicking back into how things used to be 10 years ago?
From a hockey point of view, no. You know, too much of a spectrum of some guys still playing, some guys haven't played. But a camaraderie that will always live with us is always there. It was a real tight fraternity here. And it's one of those relationships where you could be away from each other for 10 years. And the minute you're back, you're right into it. And it's been great. As you guys would say, the banter and the crack has been dynamite. It's been real good.
Your shirt's being retired today. How do you feel about that?
You know what? Coming from North America, that's a big honor, and I appreciate that. It's a great honor, and I know the club have been very good to me always, and I know that they've been trying to do it for a little while. And I think it's going to be a little extra special tonight with my family being here now, and them being a little bit older, and maybe be able to remember.
What do they make of it? What's the experience been like for them today?
You know what? I've only just seen them, so. I asked them how it's gone. They said they've had a great day. You know, it'll be much different for my wife, Corey, because she'll have seen and met tons of family and friends that we've known for a long time that she's finally been able to see again. For my children, it might have been a little bit overwhelming. You know, it's difficult. And we've had a laugh because we've taken them places where, you know, there's so much tradition and, like, you know, Chatsworth and Bakewell and places like that. And when they're kids, it's difficult. We don't know what they appreciate, you know. But we've had a great time in London, and you know. So hopefully, it's something that they'll remember and be able to look back on. I don't know how much they'll appreciate it right now. I just hope that it all goes smoothly and we have a good time.
I get the feeling it's been a very emotional experience for you this week.
It has, yeah. You know, we've been over a little bit longer than the other guys. We took it as an opportunity to have our whole family over here. We felt that was important to us as a family, and we'd been away far too long, and So it's been an emotional return visiting with friends, you know, and I use the word friends loosely, you know, like these are people that we've grown to love. We were 9 years here, you know, and we made some great bonds and some great friendships, and it's great to be back and see so many familiar faces, but definitely been an emotional time, yeah.
Finally, can you explain what kind of impact Sheffield Steelers had on your life?
Well, you know, I've spoken to lots of people about it. For me, it was virtually my 20s, you know, so it was a huge impact on me, you know. My wife had her first job here as a teacher in Baton. I went to Sheffield Hallam University. My daughter Olivia was born here. We bought our first house here. You know, we were married while we were playing here. So it's a part of our lives that is a huge part, like a full decade from 20 to 30 virtually, or 22 to 32, you know, which you can never replace. Like it'll always be with us, you know. I don't know if I can put it into words, the impact, you know, the maturity level, you know, growing up, being a little younger when I first arrived, and then when I left I was, you know, a little more educated, a little more wiser, you know, trying to behave myself a little bit more, and, you know, so it's very difficult to put into words how big it is, you know, how big a part of our lives. Like, I can't even say it's a piece or a part because it's so ingrained in our lives. You know, the memories, you know, just driving around, like, it was so comfortable. I got back in the car and I thought, you know, I was a little worried, 10 years, I don't know if I can do it.
But, wrong side of the road?
Yeah, you know, and my kids thought it was wild, you know, the wheels on the other side and all that, and but it was so comfortable, Bob, to be back, you know, in a comfortable setting where I was able to relax and had a great opportunity in life.
So a fantastic day where the legends of yesteryear came back to put on a show for the fans and players of today. For any new to the country, this will certainly be a reminder about why it's so important to win in Sheffield and exactly what the history of this hockey club is all about. So good to see so many familiar faces, and even though they've perhaps advanced in years and maybe slowed a little, some of the skills were very much there still to see. A fantastic event, and probably the first of many to come, where the Sheffield Steelers look back on their illustrious history.